In the last century, we've built megacities of steel and cement across the planet. But we've forgotten that cities are ecosystems, networks of people, habitats, and life, with expansive canopies and towering structures. The modern city has been designed for comfort and convenience. We've tried to keep the wilderness out. But nature hasn't disappeared. It's knocking at the door, and it doesn't take much to let it in. What if cities offered healthy environments, not just for us, but for the other species we share the planet with? What if instead of this, or this, we had this? Today, cities cover just 2% of the Earth's surface, but emit 70% of the CO2 emissions, and can often be up to 7 degrees hotter than the rural areas surrounding them.
How can you design so that our buildings, roadways, landscaping, start to have the same ecological performance as the wildland next door?
I truly believe that urban restoration efforts are absolutely critical.
Look, no one's suggesting giving up the comforts of modern life and returning to the wilderness. But what if we designed our cities to be more like nature? How did we get here? Humanity's story began in the forest and grasslands of Africa. Our earliest settlements developed with nature at their heart. Rivers, woodlands, pastures, and crops. As we evolved, so did our relationship with the natural world. We began to harness it as a tool. The Hanging Gardens of Babylon, for instance, used ingenious irrigation systems to cool both people and plants. The Aztecs farmed floating islands, known as chinampas, that helped nourish wetlands and fight erosion. But over time, nature was edged out as we prioritized protection and convenience. By the 20th century, concrete and cars redefined the city. We paved over ecosystems, broke up habitats, and bounced heat off tarmac. One third of all threatened species are expected to lose major habitat by 2050. And we've not just made cities uninhabitable for wildlife, we've made them hostile and unhealthy for us too.
When you walk down a street, when that street has trees and life and birds and noises in it, you know that that is a much more healthy ecosystem to be existing in.
How could this work? Some cities are already leading the way, using nature as a blueprint and partner. In Singapore, skyscrapers are wrapped in vertical forests, thousands of plants that regulate temperature, clean air, and create homes for birds and insects in the sky. In Fuzhou, China, streets, parks, and buildings are designed to act like a sponge, absorbing rainwater, slowing floods, and replenishing the groundwater naturally. In Medellin, Colombia, green corridors line roads and rivers, thousands of trees planted to combat pollution and heat. Temperatures drop by 2 degrees and could fall another 5 degrees in the coming decades. In Freetown, Sierra Leone, communities are incentivized to grow and monitor new trees across the city to combat the 70% of trees that were lost to urban sprawl, causing landslides and overheating. They've developed an app that allows them to track not just the planting of trees, but crucially, the growth. So far, over 1 million trees have been reintroduced. As technology improves, nature-inspired innovations are only going to become more accessible. Breathing building materials, water recycling systems, green walls and rooftops, natural designs. Just like nature, the variations are almost limitless. So what do we stand to gain? It's proven that cities leading the charge are reaping rewards. Living near green spaces is thought to reduce depression risk by about 20%. Tree-lined streets can be up to 4 degrees cooler. They reduce stormwater runoff by 30%. And dramatically increase biodiversity. And let's not beat around the bush. Everything else aside, living around trees is just nicer. You'd think all this comes with a cost, right? Well, wrong. Nature-based infrastructure can cost up to 50% less than traditional solutions. And the savings in flood protection, healthcare, and quality of life can deliver up to 17 times the return on investment.
We looked at every city in the world and showed how the local temperature would be affected by tree restoration in each of those cities, and it was determined by the population size and the amount of precipitation, but it can have huge impacts in reducing temperatures in many regions around the world, which would have massive impacts on human health.
Nature has been here 3.8 billion years, and in that time has learned to do everything we want to do without harm to the planet. If we were to bring nature's model into all of our designs, I think there would be a sense of belonging.
When we see ourselves as part of the ecosystem, not separate from it, we design differently. We build not just for now, but for the future.